Neste segmento, vamos apresentar uma conversa que o Mátio Correia teve com o jovem cómico Mike Rita. Mike Rita, que está a ter um sucesso enorme, especialmente depois de ter estado no programa de Gente Nossa a semana passada. Tem havido muitas pessoas a verem a comédia dele no Facebook e não só. O Mike Rita, para mim, é considerado como se fosse o Russell Peters da comunidade portuguesa. E o Mátio Correia falou com ele.
And they start talking shit about you.
E pensa que sempre dizem shit a droga. I do shit.
How funny is that? You ever smell like grass walking into a bus, Portuguese lady?
Olha, chupa um gado, oh my god. Você é uma banhão. Você é marca cebola.
Help Marcus Smula. You ever hear that one? It's that Marcus Smula. Some sort of onion. There's a bunch of stupid Portuguese sayings like that.
Merikfi. Hi, Merikfi. Merikfi.
My rich son.
Mike, what was it growing up being a comedian?
It was cool. It was different. I liked being funny when I was a kid. But the different thing is, when you grow up in a Portuguese family, it's strange to tell them that you want to follow the dream of being a performer. I mean, it's one thing to be a singer or a musician, but you just want to be straight performer, on stage, me, microphone, and that's it. And I come from a musical background. My father's a performer too, so it was like, I thought he would have supported me a little bit more, but I guess at the same time, there is no Portuguese comedians that he knows, that he likes, that he could associate success with in his mind, you know? So, yeah, but it was cool. Portuguese culture, the people are supportive because they need that. They want someone to get behind, to be like, that's our Portuguese comedian. We like that guy. Okay?
I'm a professional comedian. You know what my father said the other day? He goes, Mikey, hey, I'm very happy you make people laugh. It's nice. But one, it's not the right. Okay? Two, Mikey, não acabaste de escola. Like you.
Portuguese parents don't have that filter, you know.
Especially Portuguese women. Portuguese women are a beautiful kind, but all of our mothers, especially our mothers, they're all crazy. Every Portuguese lady, especially for our mom, you know, they're nice on the outside, but they're insane on the inside, okay? Every Portuguese lady, especially your mother will see someone she knows and go, Maria! Maria, long time no see, anda aqui dentro! And then as soon as that lady leaves, she's like, I hate that lady.
You use growing up Portuguese in your act. Where did you get your inspiration from, since you're basically a prodigy, as if I can call you that?
My inspiration comes from the funny Portuguese people that you meet throughout your life. So I use my mother a lot because my mother's actually funny. She's a funny lady. She's sassy and quick, and my father's a very funny person too. But you when you're growing up, you meet all these funny people, and what you do is you almost steal what it is that makes them funny. What is it, that little extra thing that they have that nobody else has? And you take that, when you add that to art, this beautiful thing develops, which is originality in a sense. When you take all these little inspirations, you know what I mean, and you make them your own, a beautiful thing blossoms, which is your own art in a sense. And that's, I think that's what I'm doing now with
your own passion. You put your own passion into
it
as well.
The passion is the thing, man. I couldn't have done it if I didn't believe that I could really make these people laugh that hard, you know? When I was 18 and I was starting, I didn't even have the guts to tell my mom that I was doing it, you know? I couldn't even tell her, hey mom, I'm telling jokes, because I would have thought she would have gone, you're crazy, get out of there, go get a job, you know?
Just so many funny things about being Portuguese. Where do you even start? Where do you even start? When we're little kids? Do you remember being a little kid and being raised by Portuguese parents? Do you remember when you were a kid, like Helder said it, we used to think everything was normal until you meet other races and you're like, wait a minute. Do you guys remember going to parks and camping with your uncles and your aunts and everybody getting drunk? And then everybody driving home? Do you guys, when you were kids, you're like, ah, TT's drunk! TT's on the highway? Hey, let's see what happened! Hey, let's see.
Tell me about touring across Canada with Yuck Yucks. How's that been?
That's amazing because Okay, for this crowd, it's them relating with my jokes, but when I do, let's say, Portuguese parent jokes in the East Coast, it's like I'm teaching them. It's like I'm informing them what it was like. So for these people, it's like, do you guys remember growing up Portuguese? With those people, let's say I tour and I'm BC or I'm in the East Coast, it's like growing up Portuguese was like this, instead of, do you guys remember what it was like? You just change these little feelings of how you tell the jokes. So instead of being relating with these people, you teach them and you inform them what it was like. Because Canadians want to know what it was like, you know?
Okay, now that our parents are getting old, isn't it amazing how things are changing? You ever see what the hell your parents just watch on TV? My parents watch two things, the Weather Network and Maury. That's it. They watch the Weather Network going, oh, look, time at 10, 14, now it's 11. Ace. Then my dad does that Portuguese noise. My mom watches Maury all day. I catch her at home, 3 o'clock, eating pudding. My grande vez, essa mulher, tão três filhos, um satão, já não sabe. Stupid lady.
What's the message you have to Portuguese youths out there that want to go into comedy or into another profession of sorts, and as you said, the parents don't really support it. What's your message to them?
Portuguese youth need to start at the core and build a mentality that education and chasing dreams is okay? Right now, when I was in high school, nobody cared about graduating. It wasn't even the top of your list of things. It first was like, you know, construction, like, can I leave school right now and get a job, because I will right now and do that. There is no Portuguese youth. My message to them is literally follow your heart and don't let other people tell you what you think is right. If you want to go to school and get an education, do that. Don't think because you're a Portuguese male you have to drop out and work. You can go to school, you can be smart, you can do something, okay? Do something with your life, be fun.
Keep on making people laugh, and thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you guys, man. Gente Nossa TV and everybody out there, thank you so much.
And the best thing is, listen, we all grew up in Canada and we all know what the hell drugs are. But the worst is our parents don't know what drugs are. Because they don't know. Canadian parents know. Canadian parents catch you smoking grass, guess what? They're like, oh, you're smoking grass? Well, guess what? At least it's not cocaine, methamphetamine, heroin. Okay? They know. Portuguese parents aren't like that. You're never going to see a Portuguese lady and be like, Mike, you see that guy? And film a crack. And screw with his brain. And that's why he don't understand it. My mother didn't know that. Listen, I've grown up in Toronto my whole life. And I grew up on Lansdowne and Bloor. Don't clap for Lansdowne and Bloor. Toronto's a beautiful city, but you know what? You know what the big giveaway you live in a shitty area is? Coffee times. Lansdowne used to have 4 coffee times. Why? So a crackhead could be like, hey, let's go to the next one. I forgot I used to see crackheads with my mom when I was a little kid, and my mom didn't know how to explain a crackhead. Portuguese parents do not know how to explain it. My mother doesn't know, and I remember when I was a kid, we used to see them do the crazy shit. I seen one time move across the street without moving his legs, okay? He vibrated the whole way like a cell phone on a table. And I remember looking at my mom, and she doesn't know, she's religious. She goes, Mom, how's he doing that? How's he doing that? My mom doesn't know. She goes, he don't like Jesus.
Quero desejar muito sucesso ao Mike, Rita, e nós temos fotografias do Mike quando ele era pequenino. Para quem não sabe quem era, o Mike fazia parte do grupo da amizade, o grupo que natural da Ribeira Quente, que tem feito muitos espetáculos e tem lançado CDs também com o Ferramenta, que é o mestre da Ferramenta, vamos lá dizer, o mestre do grupo da amizade. E o Mike era o que tocava o acordeão assim ao lado do Paulo, só quando era mais criança, e veio muitas vezes também à nossa adega do David Correia, onde nós também fazíamos sempre aquela festa dos reis, onde cantar as estrelas, cantar os reis com o grupo da amizade. É ele que está a ter muito sucesso e eu espero que a comunidade o apoie, que vayam ver e procure para ir ver, porque o que ele diz faz a gente rir, mas são realidades. E é importante muitas das coisas que ele diz, porque assim as pessoas ficam a saber e a aprender como é que certas coisas marcam as pessoas na nossa vida de dia a dia, na nossa maneira de ser, nas nossas famílias portuguesas. É muito cómico, é muito bonito e é realmente um grande sucesso. Parabéns ao Mike Rita. Vamos agora ter mais bons conselhos dos nossos patrocinadores e logo a seguir eu tenho um convidado em estúdio, Manuel da Costa. Vamos falar sobre o Portuguese Walk of Fame.